How's it going? It's FamKam, and welcome to Getting Over It with Bennett Foddy. This game is specifically designed to frustrate the hell out of the player. You're a guy in a cauldron trying to climb his way up the mountain using a pickaxe, swinging in circular motions. And it's about getting over it. It's like, we're gonna get over it. That being said, let's get started. Alright. It's go time. Bump. Dang it. Oh, already failing. Come on. Nope. There we go. So, occasionally music pops up in this game, but I have muted it due to copyright reasons. And so, if you hear music in the background, that's because I put in royalty-free music. Link to the source will be in the description.
If you got your best shirt dry cleaned before a wedding, and then immediately dropped food on it. If you want an argument with a friend, and then later discovered that they just returned to their original view.
Oh, I've been there many times.
It's harder than starting up. If you're not ready for that, like if you've already had a bad day,
damn.
What you're about to go through might be hard. Feel free to go away and come back.
No.
I'll be here.
Hope you're having a wonderful day or night.
I don't understand if you have to take a break at any point.
Okay.
Just find a safe place to stop and quit the game. Don't worry. I'll save your progress, always. Even your mistakes.
Yeah, I know, you'll save my mistakes.
This game is a homage to a free game that came out in 2002, titled Sexy Hiking. The author of that game was Jazzor, a mysterious Czech designer who was known at the time as the father of B-games. And B-games are rough assemblages of found objects. Designers slap them together very quickly and freely, and they're often too rough and unfriendly to gain much of a following. They're built more for the joy of building them than as polished products.
I've actually tried the game.
Sexy Hiking is the perfect embodiment of a B-game.
Yeah, I've actually tried Sexy Hiking, and this is definitely a major improvement over it.
In it, your task is simply to drag yourself up a mountain with a hammer.
There we go. There we go.
Climbing, in the digital world or in real life, has certain essential properties that give the game its flavor. No amount of forward progress is guaranteed. Some cliffs are too sheer or too slippery, and the player is constantly, unremittingly in danger.
Man, I knocked the coffee away. Oh, no. That's okay.
Anyway, when you start Sexy Hiking, you're standing next to this dead tree that blocks the way to the entire rest of the game. It might take you an hour to get over that tree. A lot of people never got past it.
Oh, my God.
You poke at it, exploring the limits of your reach and your strength, trying to find a way up and over. And there's a sense of truth in that lack of compromise. Most obstacles in video game worlds are fake. You can be completely confident in your ability to get through them once you have the correct method or the correct equipment or just by spending enough time. In that sense, every pixelated obstacle in Sexy Hiking is real.
Are you kidding me right now? Yes. There we go. No, I keep knocking myself off that same spot every
time.
That's
a deep frustration. A real punch in the gut.
Relax. This is both me trying to get you to relax and trying to get myself to relax simultaneously. This part's easy.
The obstacles in Sexy Hiking are unyielding, and that makes the game uniquely frustrating. But I'm not sure Jazuo intended to make a frustrating game. The frustration is just essential to the act of climbing, and it's authentic to the process
of
building
a
game
about it.
A funny thing happened to me as I was building this mountain. I'd have an idea for a new obstacle, and I'd build it, test it, and it would usually turn out to be unreasonably hard. But I couldn't bring myself to make it easier. It already felt like my inability to get past the new imaginary mountains build themselves from our efforts to climb.
Oh
and
my god, that catch though.
Summit that turns those mountains into something real. When you're building a video game world, you're building with ideas. And that can be like working with quickset cement. You mold your ideas into a certain shape that can be played with. And in the process of playing with them, they begin to harden and set until they're immutable, like rock. And at that point, you can change the world. Not without breaking it into pieces and starting fresh with new ideas.
Jump. Oh my god, I had it. We can do this. We can do this. Oh, we didn't do it. Boy, this is a problem. Okay, no problem. Wait, I just said it is a problem. I'm losing it. Okay. No, 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 no. Okay, there, and I'll you. No, no, no. My way this way. Good, 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 good. Yes. Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh my god. Why did I decide to play this game? Because I'm getting over it. That's the whole point of this video. We're getting over it. Stick out his tongue. It looked like he did. Oh my god. I'm not happy. I hope you are happy. Because if you are, that'll make me happy. Oh boy. first time did not work. Damn it, Bennett Foddy. Hate you. Yes. I almost had that second light. Once I grab hold of the second light, I'm home free. Watch, I do, and I'm not. No. Oh my god, I would have been so livid if I fell there. Oh my god, don't do this to me.
For years now, people have been predicting that games would soon be made out of prefabricated objects, bought in a store and assembled into a world. And for the most part, that hasn't happened, because the objects in the stores are trash. I don't mean they look bad or that they're badly made, although a lot of them are. I mean they're trash in the way that food becomes trash as soon as you put it in the sink. Things are made to be consumed and used in a certain context, and once the moment is gone, they transform into garbage. In the context of technology, those moments pass by in seconds.
Wow.
Over time, we've poured
was too close. Why do they put that there? This is not funny. Unbelievable. Wow. Supposed to this